Hello everyone, my name is Anuj. I'm a second year MBBS student at GMC Nagpur and welcome to my channel. And if you're new here, I extend a very warm welcome to you and hope that you are perfectly safe and alright. The purpose of making this video is that like 9 or 10 months ago when I first made a video on this particular topic, now when I look back to it, I feel like it is not really that sufficient and does not cover a lot of details which I'll cover on this video. Before we begin further, what is the purpose of taking notes? What is the reason that we are actually doing this practice of copying basically parts of the textbook and making a new textbook? The first reason is, my friends, that before the end of any examination, be it university or be it any competitive entrance examination, we want a set of only the important points which we can look at it very quickly. The next reason is that whenever you are studying something, you want a quick revision, a quick written revision of whatever you have studied, and that is the only two reasons why anybody ever takes notes. Before going deep into this topic, I want to state a few facts. First of all is that you don't want to overdo this, because in the end you want to have limited number of things to read and not a lot of things to read. Next thing is, your notes will be better than notes given by anybody. The reason is because your notes are personalized to you. And the third thing is, every single subject is different and every single person is different. So it might happen with some of you that whatever that I'm saying here may not resonate with you. In the initial part, I'll be talking about physical note taking, and the later part will be talking about the digital note taking. So let's talk first about the physical note taking. In university, as you know, most of the universities have a perfect set of important questions, and only from those important questions the universities tend to pick out the questions and make the question paper. It is what is seen with our university, and I'm sure many other universities also have the same thing. A question that I keep getting the most is, if I'm taking notes, should I be taking notes from an entire chapter or should I be taking notes from only a part of the chapter? For that, let me tell you a story. If you are reading a chapter of, let's say, circulatory shock, and let's say if you are reading a chapter of anemias, in circulatory shock, every single word is important. And so what I feel, according to the importance of the topics, the amount of notes should correlate. That means if a chapter is big and it is important, you should have notes from that big chapter. If you are reading anemias, you encounter so many different types of anemia. Let's say you're reading megaloblastic anemia, and let's say you have read hereditary spherocytosis. Which one of them is more important? Obviously, clinically also, megaloblastic anemia will be more important. So the amount of notes which should be coming out from a particular topic is completely determined by what is the importance of that topic in your nazariya and the nazariya of the university. My friends, the first phase of note taking, as I talked about in my last video, is reading the concept. And if you are reading it for the university point of view, then reading it on the basis of importance is what you should do. And if you are not reading it for the university process, if you just want to know what is present in the book and how everything is given in the chapter, feel free to read everything. First reading is very important, and it will make you understand what things are important, how everything is working. Only then will you able to take your note. So phase one was that. Phase two is the actual process of note taking. Let's dive into the techniques that we use for taking notes. First things first, you do not want to have a lot of paragraphs in your notes. As Samuel Suresh put it in his YouTube video, he said that the process of learning anything is basically taking that thing which is written in a book or in a video lecture, breaking it down into constituents, and then assimilating the constituents yourself in a different format. So my friends, note taking is the process of breaking down complex things which are written in the book into a simpler format. How we do it is not by writing paragraphs, but by actually understanding the concept first and then using different methods to break that down into digestible bites. The first method that I want every single one of you to practice next time is that use points, and use points only. Especially if you are reading something very conceptual like pathology, which has a lot of points and a lot of things you have to remember, there is no need to make paragraphs and paragraphs of notes, just write in points. The other thing is, one of my favorite techniques which actually led me to top anatomy in first year is that diagrams. And not just in anatomy, we tend to ignore diagrams in our preclinical and clinical subjects also. For example, pharmacology. It may sound weird to you, but an entire drug can be summed up using one diagram itself. So my friends, diagrams for anatomy or any other subject in any place, if you find the potential that you can make diagrams, you should make it. Let's take an example. First of all, if you're reading something such as HNF from anatomy, it is a bit complicated. According to your priorities, you will determine what you have to read. The parotid gland has so many relations, the temporomandibular joint has so many relations. Instead of memorizing every single relation in every single aspect, just make a diagram. Another example of this is the middle ear. If you have studied anatomy, you have probably encountered this topic called as the middle ear. Instead of just memorizing all the relations of which wall has which relation, you can just make one diagram from Gray's Anatomy, and that would solve your entire problem of memorizing relations. That was for anatomy. If you are not able to understand a drug such as digoxin, which is a cardiac glycoside, you can make one diagram on its mechanism of action. In fact, for every single drug, you can make a mechanism of action and how that mechanism of action fits into its pharmacological uses, its side effects, its adverse effects, and all of that. So my friends, diagrams are way more underrated than you can possibly imagine. And what I've felt in all my years of writing papers is that the more diagrams you draw, basically, it directly correlates to how much marks you can get. The third thing is flowcharts. Instead of memorizing the entire pathway in a paragraph format, you can make flowcharts. For example, let's go back to the pathogenesis of, let's say, G6PD deficiency anemia. Instead of memorizing that a person, if given an oxidant drug such as chloroquine, will develop anemia, you can just make a flowchart out of how that anemia particularly develops. That NADPH is deficient, so glutathione dehydrogenase is deficient. So it leads to failure of detoxification of oxygen species, and hence finally RBC cell damage, and finally cell death. You see, flowcharts can break down complex things into very simpler bytes, and you can just look at it once. The next thing, my friends, is tables. There was a particular topic in physiology last year, and it was a very important and interesting topic, that was the cardiac cycle. And if you remember the cardiac cycle, there are so many phases with so many durations, and you gotta have it bit pat in first year at least, so that you can definitely make a copy out of it when an examination question appears. My friends, while reading physiology, I found out that if I had made a one perfect table out of what I was talking about, the cardiac cycle, then in the end, if I know that table, I can break that table down into flowchart, I can break that table down into your diagrams, I can make it into a theory and a paragraph and a point format. One flowchart will give you access to all of the things which you have dreamed of. So make flowcharts, make diagrams, make points, and make your own tables. The last point, my friends, is mnemonics. And mnemonics are very important when you are reading entities which have a multiple orientation. Let's take the classical example of cephalosporins. If you are reading third generation cephalosporins, I won't even like to name them right now, because if I start naming every single one of them, then the video will have a lot of cut, and I don't want that. Anyways, the mnemonic breaks it down into very simpler things which you can have. The next thing is phase 3. Phase 3 is nothing but revision or reviewing your work. Since my last videos, I keep on telling that how important reviewing your work can be. And I want you all to do that yourself. Because if you have taken notes, immediately revising it after a few moments or after a few minutes will just incorporate those pathways which you might have heard in a lecture or might have read in your textbooks. So reviewing your topic is the third phase of making notes. So my final tip for this entire thing is, if you're preparing for university examination, make a separate copy which has question and answers format notes of all the important topics that are given here. By the way, I was thinking about making a video on how to prepare for university examinations. Let me know if you would want to see that, maybe. That concludes everything that I have to say about physical note taking. Anyways, thank you so much for watching my video. If this video even added a tiny bit of value to your life, please give this a thumbs up, because it means so much more than anything. You don't even have an idea what it means to me. And my friends, if you're here for the first time and if you like this video, perhaps check out some of my other ones, and kindly subscribe to the channel, because every single one of you matters. No matter how big this channel grows, it's still in its infancy, I think. each and every single one of you will have my love and my respect. So thank you for doing that. And as always, stay safe, stay healthy, and stay happy. Until next time, I will see you soon.